Welcome everyone to another class. What was the subject for this class?
Spiral.
Happy Sacadas, yeah, spiral. We're doing more spiral tomorrow, by the way. And what orchestra did we play for the whole class? That's the Canaro, right? Who's his brother?
Rafael
Fit, excellent. So we're trying to use Canaro as a little bit more uplifting, not that all the songs are uplifting, some of them are kind of sad, but has kind of a nice bouncy rhythm. It's fun to play with it, not too fast for the most part. So it's pretty easy to get started on Sacadas. What's the first test you do at you after the warm-up dance?
How many cicadas can you do in a row?
Yeah, how many cicadas can you do in a row? Did anyone get up to like 20? Yeah, good. So what are some things that keep these things continuous? Well, let's talk about real estate. What's going on in the space? Follower needs more space. How much more space? I step where relative to her hips?
Tangent.
Yeah, tangent. And then here she can just walk around me. Long. Close. Tangent. Do I want to look at her? Or do I want to look at her? What is another property? What is another resource of quality about this specific movement?
The ocho.
So it's a combination of a turn and a big
ocho. Big ocho. Who's doing the ocho?
The important thing is that ocho gets you in position for the next move. So here you join ocho. I get ahead of her hips, then I just walk into her. Then she does ocho. She's ready to walk into me. Eventually, this becomes very continuous.
So, what about her embrace powers? How can she be?
Elastic.
So, it's always so challenging for us to explain this idea of, I have good contact with my hands on my leader, wherever it is, with his head or his back or his shoulder, but the rest of my arm is nice and elastic. There's a moment that my arms are really extended, and then there's a moment that my arms are really compact, but nothing changes with the contact of my fingertips.
And leaders are trying to do this how? In what manner? Sugar bowl or teapot, basically without using what part of the anatomy? The forearm and hand, which you'd like to pull from behind. And that creates extra aggravation. It rushes our partners, doesn't allow them to be flexible in their own embrace. It doesn't give them the space oftentimes that they need. Sometimes you have to let go completely, especially on the harder side. What's the general theory of followers' sacadas?
Reaching, okay, I reached. And what?
Arriving.
How am I arriving? Yes, how many quarters do I have? Four. At least if I'm making a goal in any of my steps. Then for a moment, when I arrive, the four quarters of my standing foot are really connected to the floor. Even if I'm wearing really high heels or my leader is moving fast. I want to give myself the opportunity to really completely arrive and be okay there before reaching to the next step. Instead of worrying, where is the next step? Where is the next step? Instead, worry about how am I arriving? Am I really here? Am I really here? Yeah.
For survival technique leaders, we're going to use the demo of the fear of line of dance. You can walk it around, if for some reason you find yourself against the line of dance, one, and maybe you should turn it around right away.
Yeah.
Okay. Or maybe you can do two in a row, do a shoulder check with a little bit of space, and then you can turn that around. So there are many ways to manage the follower sacadas socially. I've done it for many years now, so they shouldn't be taboo.